very compact defense.
Folayang's very dangerous with his kicks.
Yes.
Lightning fast.
This fight brought to you by Colt 45, the official beer of 1FC. Folayang eats a left jab from Edamoto. Wearing the black trunks, Folayang in red.
Really good reach on his strikes too. That two came from really far out.
The smart Araneta Coliseum in almost silence until Edward threw that right leg kick. So intense are the audience here.
That's one of the main differences you see in the Asian communities versus the United States, when there's a little bit of a, not to say a lull in the action, but the Asian communities, in Japan especially, they tend to be very quiet during the fights. They really respect what's going on, not only the martial arts aspect of it, but from the fighter's standpoint. Here in the USA, people are just much more rowdy.
Another good long right hand there a moment ago from Enomoto.
Both guys taking the first minute and a half here to feel each other out, gauge that distance. Ooh, nice right hand, and it followed up with a nice leg kick.
And then the left hand came in as well, and another kick. Using his left leg there to damage the right side of Enomoto.
We talked about earlier, you know, guys from the same gyms tend to almost emulate each other in their striking or their grappling, and talk about Enzo's and all the Team Wakai guys. Very similar how they mix up their straight punches, their angles, throwing those kicks from different angles. And the more comfortable that Folayang feels like he is here, another nice shot to the ribs, the more he's going to be able to open up with his arsenal.
Enomoto's stance is high-handed, as I said before. That right hand is close to the face, but it's an open defense he has. It's not tight by any means.
Folayang really throws hard. Look, he's sitting here cage side. These punches that are missing are just a couple of inches off of breaking cinder blocks. And Enomoto is doing a really good job, too, of you know, gauging his distance and working that jab. He wants to really exploit that distance that he has. Letting Folayang get inside and work the body isn't the way to win this fight.
Really super left jab from Folayang a moment ago.
Good kick.
Catching Enomoto just to the side of the left eye.
You know, typically when you see guys that have a lightning fast spinning back kick,
he does that a lot, and he'll also throw a spinning punch as well. He did that quite a lot against Larson, and I have to say, not to good effect with the punch. The spinning kick can do some damage, and has done.
Well, you know, if this becomes a brawl, I think it's going to favor Eduard Folayang, because when we saw him and Larson, I mean, that was just back and forth action, and it really showed that both these guys can take a big punch.
Took a good left hand from Enomoto and gave him a little nod of appreciation as well.
You know, I think Enomoto is still having a difficult time finding his range here. He hasn't really landed anything on Folayang. It's been too detrimental. I really like to see him work that jab a little more, since he, as you pointed out, he has a reach advantage. If nothing else, he can use that to see what Folayang's game plan is going to be.
Jab to the body, I always think is a dangerous way to attack, but Folayang does it so quickly there, doesn't really give Felipe much chance to come back at him. And there's a right-left-right combination.
Got great movement. Nice 1-2 by Enomoto, just took him off balance a little bit.
Approaching the final minute of this opening round.
Folayang works the body a lot like Mike Tyson does. He just kind of sits down and he throws those 2-3 body shots and puts his hips really nicely behind him. You know, body shots won't necessarily knock you out, but it's a nice kick, but it just really breaks down your wind. Messes up your breathing pattern. Enomoto's a little stiff boxing. He's got good movement. He's flicking that jab out there, but his combinations, he's been throwing with his head up.
Yes, I agree.
Again, having a hard time getting in that range, because every time he gets close, he gets 3 or 4 from Folayang.
There is a bit of a contrast there. You say that Enomoto's a bit stiff, but Folayang moves so well, doesn't he? Very fluid,
right,
both hands.
Yeah, well, I think Enomoto's just really having a hard time setting up his timing, really. And the range is there. But Folayang's been, for precision of getting in and out with his punches.
Kick to the rib cage there for Folayang as this first round comes to a close. And probably the Filipino edge that first 5 minutes.
But good action. I mean, Folayang doing a very good job of defending the single leg there. And the only time that I thought Anamoto put a really good shot in there was that left hook that he countered off with. But Folayang's been lightning quick. That kick was a little short to be completely devastating,
yes,
but just right on the money and super fast.
Did land. Second round. That's Kim Ha-Yul. That's Felipe Anamoto. That's Eduard Folayang.
I'm Jason Chambers, and you're Steve Dawson. I'm good at this game too, huh? I was really good at who's that guy.
This fight sponsored by Colt 45, and a good right hand from Folayang. Follows it up with a few more. The left hand caught Enomoto as well. Doesn't seem overly perturbed by it. Takes the center ring.
Folayang, I would say, out of all the Team Lakai guys that I've seen fight, probably has the best wrestling defense. He's shown some very good takedown defense. I mean, not as much in this fight, because there's only been one, you know, discernible takedown attempt, but he fought off a couple good attempts from Ole Larsen, and again, super quick. Once Folayang gets inside, he's able to unleash those combinations.
Oh, left and right hand from Eduard.
Yeah, just like that, he's able to mix up the angles well. Anamoto is still sticking with those 1-2s.
Yeah, it perhaps is the fluidity of Eduard's punches that may gain him the edge. Can just move that little bit quicker and come in from a slightly more, a bigger variety of angles. Perhaps Enomoto a little bit predictable. Oh, and two-handed attack from the Filipino again. The crowd roar, and that was a solid right hand. Follows it up with a very stiff jab. He's taken big punches, but you can't really say that Enomoto has been rocked yet. He's been pushed back.
You know, and the ironic part is that he's been moving forward the whole fight, and it's very difficult. There's only a handful of guys that are successful counterpunchers, like Folayang is moving backwards.
These two really well matched. It's a very absorbing contest. The right hand's coming in from Eduard again. He's having a super round.
It was a good chopping leg kick.
Big kick, wasn't it? Folayang has tree trunk-like legs, though.
See, Anamoto's just overextending himself on that cross. You see when he throws that right, it's not straight down the center. He's coming off his base a lot, and it's a nice right kick. And Folayang's able to come back and counter and beat him to those punches. I really would like to see Anamoto use that jab more. Kind of a pawing right hand there.
But he's nice. Really targeting that left leg of Folayang, isn't he?
I think that's smart. I mean, so far, Folayang hasn't had an answer for it. He's connected with three of his last three.
As Enomoto came in there, he got caught with a short left. The amount of times that Eduard spins round in a contest, I don't think I've seen any fighter do that quite so much. Left and right.
That jab came in and just landed right on the chin.
Really got the bit between his teeth now, Folayang.
Nice side kick. And Folayang just, he puts everything out there with intent. Even his jabs are hard. Boy, I tell you, if we could just go slow motion on Falayong's face, you can see that he just has intent behind every one of those punches.
Look at Enomoto coming forward the whole time, despite the barrage that he receives, the heavy punches that he's eating.
Well, I think that it's smart, too, because by coming forward, it's you don't really want Folayang coming forward on you, right? I mean, that's what happens. So, you know, they're keeping him on his toes. I just think he needs to mix the game up.
Tremendously aggressive from Eduard. He takes a punch early so as to open up his opponent and then comes in with the counter and then just doesn't stop.
Just missed with that right hand.
It's a mark under Enomoto's right eye.
Yeah, Enomoto just throwing that 1-2 out there again. Not really, turning his hands over too much on him. Start turning his hips over too much on those kicks either.
Well, the action is furious here. What an entertaining contest this is.
Folayang did a good job there, stuffing the shot.
1 minute left in the second round.
you see Folayang has good instincts. He knows when Anamono's inside of the shots, and he needs to make his number one priority to peel him up there and to fight that hand grip and head placement. He's not trying to reach over him or throw anything crazy to knock him out while he's getting the takedown. He knows that that's the immediate threat.
Enomoto comes in with that jab and has to take really big punches from Eduard. There it is. Not all of them land.
Oh, that was a good shot.
Big right hand.
A right hand, and Enomoto goes down and now takes the barrage of punches.
Look at the finish
here. Coming from Enomoto's nose. The punches still come down.
I don't know if he's going to have enough time here with 15 seconds left. He's got to be careful he doesn't get caught with an armbar here by throwing those punches.
Just able to survive. He's got 10 seconds left in this second round. The crowd are on their feet at cage side. Hammer blows from Folayang. It's not going to be enough. Referee Moritaka Oshiro comes in to separate them at the end of that second round, and it's another huge stanza for Eduard Folayang, who will enter this third round, for my money, well ahead.
That was a great, great, just technical arsenal he threw at Enomoto there. You saw a couple of punches that got right down the center. And we take a look at it from the other angle here. That right hand snuck through. And again, just right behind the ear, he's able to catch Enomoto a couple of times, work the body.
Oh!
Overhand to the right.
You saw Enomoto's head.
Enomoto didn't feel like there was anything on those punches.
Fight!
It's just a very precise bruise. And I think Enomoto knows that he's coming into this final round of this fight, which is brought to you by Colt 45, knowing that he's got to do something pretty special.
Well, there's definitely the sense of urgency now. I mean, you're 10 minutes into a 15-minute fight. The takedown hasn't really been there for you, and the punches you've been getting the short end of the stick on, so this is where you need to start.
Oh, versatile. Good shot from Enomoto. A shower of sweat and moisture came off Folayang's head. And you heard the slapping sound here, cage side.
You know, if Enomoto put together a couple more combinations, I think he could open up that shot more down Folayang, but he's just throwing 1-2 and he's backing off because Folayang's coming in there. It's just like that, he threw 1-2. You know, sometimes he's connecting with that because of the extra reach, but anytime he's tried to really put together a bigger combination, Folayang's got better on the inside.
I'm trying to get a good look at this. I think Enomoto is bleeding from the nose. He keeps pawing at it as well. Blood's not streaming down, but
Enomoto, you know, to his credit, still has a lot of gas left in the tank. You can tell
he's
light
moving
on his feet.
Well. Yeah. In fact, he's looking a little bit more fluid than he has done in the first two rounds, where we both remarked that he was a little bit stiff. Edward nearly stumbled there again after that spinning kick that he likes to employ.
Well, Eduard Folayang is definitely a difficult guy to take down. And it's smart, you know, he plays to his strengths. Obviously, in mixed martial arts, you want to train everywhere, but if primarily you're a striker.
Left and right from Eduard.
Tuning up that wrestling to help keep the fight where you want, it's going to be key.
Oh, that was a big haymaker. It wasn't really anywhere near the target. But it just shows how much energy Eduard has. He's really fit for the three-round of five-minute contest. Oh, and he took a big right hand there when he was off balance and stayed up.
Fuck, Folayang, right in the chin there. It's hard to tell if he was more off balance because he's holding a kick or if that really rocked that room. Oh, nice jab from the center there.
It's Eduard coming forward now. In the second round, we saw Felipe Enomoto inching forward. He puts everything into his punches, Folayang. Sometimes they perhaps lack a little bit of finesse, but when he lands, he really lands.
Yeah, he's finishing the fences. There's no doubt about that. He's not trying to win a point-scoring contest.
Just took that big stiff left jab from Enomoto and brings the knee up as well. The Japanese fighter spends much of his time in Switzerland, where he has his own gym, works very hard with his brother.
You know, Felipe Enomoto, he's very tough. I mean, this guy has fought a few different UFC vets, so he knows what it's like to be in there with high-level guys. Fought Rich Clemente back in 2010. Completely different fighter than Eduard Folayang is, but you know, so that wealth of experience that other guys have had in there, he knows how to weather storms and see those openings.
These two have been in each other's faces since the start. They're not giving any ground.
And if there's one thing we learned from the fight he had with Ole Larson is that you really can't count Edamoto out, because this fight looked almost identical with
sure,
Ole.
Sure, he and pulled that one out the bag, didn't he? Whew.
Pulled it out the back, zipped it up, sealed it, and it was over.
And he just caught Edward as Edward was going back with a nice cheeky little left hand to the chin. There goes the kick to the inside of Folayang's left thigh. 54 seconds left in the final round. And the crowd here making a bit of noise, knowing that if things continue to go this way, their man, Eduard Folayang, has a very good chance of coming away with a decision. But while Enomoto's standing and throwing punches, anything could happen. How are the judges viewing this? Looking at the fight as a whole, not round by round, remember. Two great athletes, just giving absolutely everything. Not once have they tried to take a breather, and Enomoto goes down. Open attack single by the referee. Enomoto with his hands behind his head. We're in the final 10 seconds, and you figure not a great deal's going to happen in that time. But down goes Edward. One last flash of him, but he got kicked back and had to retreat. That's the end of the fight. And both men show the respect that you always knew they would. And it goes to the judges' decisions.
The winner by unanimous decision in the red corner, Eduard Folayang.
Ready, fight!
Both men rush to the center of the cage and then stop. Whoa, there's a big swinging overhand right from Edouard that landed well short, but that jab was a nice sharp one. Kicks from Latul.
Oh, Folayang definitely is going to have the advantage here in both the striking prowess and just the physical prowess. And it looks like he may be able to go for the takedown there. Surprised that, that Edouard would even look for the takedown. Maybe he wants to show the world his new and improved grappling abilities.
He looks so strong for a lightweight, doesn't he, Folayang? So thick set around the stomach and the quads there, shoulders.
Yeah, he definitely has a very good build for the lightweight division.
Using the shoulder there, Latour. Both arms are tied up. Precious little else he can use in the upper torso.
Latul has double underhooks. If he can just collapse his hands together, he has the right leverage
action
to be able to take Folayang down. But Folayang's keeping his hips turned away, so that makes it a little more difficult. But a wealth of experience.
And break! Ray. More action, fight!
Edward, like we've seen in the past, gonna wanna mix those strikes up with the kicks. Mixes up all of his angles very well.
So many Team Lakai fighters can do that seamlessly, can't they? And Edward can exhibit that as well as anyone.
Well, Latul's very comfortable in the cage, that's for sure. He's a little more flat-footed, but... Oh, and a nice takedown by Folayang.
Great sequence of action there, then. The kick from Latul, great punch from Edouard, and then the takedown.
Looks like Folayang is setting up a far side armbar here. Oh, he just missed, but I looks like he was trying to sneak that in. This is Latul's very, very, very familiar area of MMA on his back. He is very comfortable throwing up triangles and armbars from here. Folayang just has to be careful that he doesn't get careless and leave any limbs out.
He may not get them back.
But there comes a bit of ground and pound. But taking a heel to the face, which is always a brutal, brutal piece of punishment to take.
Well, Folayang's doing a good job of just stuffing the tool against the cage. That doesn't give him any room to go. The tool needs to either wall walk here or put his feet on the hips and explode and create some distance so he can get up and not eat those shots.
Again, that heel pressed towards the face there from Atul. But as Jason said, he's just jammed up against that cage there. Oh, he missed with that, but he gave it a good go.
He missed and went right into cross-eyed, I guess, if you got a miss. Improving position's a good way to do it.
Yes.
Yeah, Folayang's keeping that hand. I'm sorry, Latul's keeping that right hand on Folayang's hip, trying to create some space.
Entering the final minute of the opening round, and the crowd really getting into this one.
Yeah, he's been getting just a barrage of punches and elbows, though. Even though he's doesn't look like there's any massive damage being done, Folayang's just been grounding and pounding his way to a W in this first third of the fight.
This crowd chanting Eduard's name. For many of them, this is the man they came to see tonight.
Well, Atul has to do something here. He's connected with a couple of those up kicks, but really nothing that anyone's going to write home about when the judges look at the scorecards. Another right hand.
Forearm to the chin. Folayang throwing whatever he can towards Latul's face.
Folayang's just keeping really good pressure, both with his body weight and also just staying on top of Latul to get those strikes in. Not really giving Latul a chance to work here.
Yeah, he's maintained this position for the greater part of the second half of that opening round, and Folayang will feel as he walks back to his corner men that he had the better of that round.
Well, we saw Eduard kind of ducked under a couple of the punches there of Latul and got a nice double leg takedown and moved into cross mount. And he was able to throw heavy punches down, all were unanswered by Latul. Latul was able to get in a couple of up kicks, but that big right hand that came bringing down from Eduard Folayang has really been able to control the pace and the tempo of the ground game here.
Now we've spoken about. Oh, let's listen and see if we can hear what's going on. We've spoken about how vulnerable Eduard can be to cuts. Christine Hallower telling us that this is the start of round two. There's a swelling underneath Edward's left eye, and that's why they had that flat iron against it. It's kept in an ice box, it's very cold, and it's quite effective in reducing the swelling. Let's see how that deteriorates possibly as the fight goes on.
Oh, and a big right hand over the top by Folayang.
Just missed, didn't he, with the follow-up left.
Yeah, if he was able to follow up with that, that could have been lights out.
Yeah.
That was square on the chin, but Latul just ate that with mayo.
Good short right hand from Latul. We've seen Eduard do that before. He likes to do that at least once every contest.
Well, Edwards letting his hands go now, mixing up the angles, back in on a nice single leg here. Well, Latul tried to grab a guillotine choke, but it's going to be really hard for him to finish it from this angle because he doesn't have the leverage. Unless Lyon's just panicked, it's going to be next to impossible to finish the choke from this position. You just don't have the leverage to create the distance and the pressure on your opponent's neck.
It's hard work for Latul. You can see in his face just holding. But there goes Eduard. Elbows, fists.
Well, Eduard can just start to move his right knee over the hip of Latul and start to create space just like that. Even that forearm is going to help him slowly inch that choke out. You see Latul is trying his hardest to hold on to this. He knows that if Eduard postures up, he's going to be in another bad spot and have to get a little payback for this choke attempt.
Latul's got the right hand in there, holding it tight. Now he's let it go now.
He's almost out. That left forearm across the throat of Latul is what's going to help Eduard pry his head out, just like that.
Greeted to loud cheers from the crowd here when Eduard released his head from that guillotine move. And now he goes to work with the forearm.
Eduard looks like a shower. He's pouring sweat. That means he's well hydrated. When your body's needs the hydration, it doesn't let the sweat come out.
And as you often tell us, it makes for a tough grip. But these punches coming in from Eduard are unanswered. 12 or 15 of them there, the knee in, the forearms as well. Latul taking a lot of punishment. Yuji's asking the question. He wants to hear from Latul. Are you all right? 25 to 30 unanswered blows from Eduard now. Latul is taking a huge amount of punishment.
Yeah, Yuji's yelling at Latul, defend, defend, defend. And, you know, laying on your back like that, if Yuji just feels like... If Yuji feels like, you know, you're in danger and you're not cognizant of defending yourself, well, he could fully step in there and stop the fight. But you know, no one's a master like Yuji is. And if he does stop the fight here, he's given Latour plenty of opportunities to really defend or
plenty is an understatement. This is 60, 50 to 60 punches now.
Well, I think the only thing to say really is that the punches are kind of small rabbit punches, and even though they look good,
sure. They're
not really doing a lot of damage. But, you know, that arm across the face
across
here,
the
Folayang,
face, yeah.
He could really get a choke, and if he steps, freezes legs, and steps over to the left side of Latul.
Oh, that's great
bam,
work.
Right there, he's going to squeeze this in here. This is a head and arm choke.
He's in a world of trouble.
This could be the beginning of the end. Latul signaling, I'm okay, but Folayang says, not if I have anything to say about it.
Listen to this crowd. Will he tap?
Folayang needs to get his head down lower to really create more leverage here. And also, he doesn't have his left arm underneath the arm there. He's got this.
Oh, he slips out.
So close, but so far on that. Just needed to make little adjustments to the technique.
Fight!
Oh, he ate that head kick.
Really did. Folayang is well on top, and that's a big right hand, and the crowd are absolutely loving this. It's a racket here at cage side. Oh, and a big takedown.
Huge double leg from Eduard Folayang.
What a performance to make these guys and girls happy at cage side.
You can't get a double leg that looks any cleaner than that. I don't care if you're Ben Askren, okay? That was a beautiful flare double leg. Yeah, up kicking Eduard Folayang probably just makes him a little more upset with you. And he's passing guard. The thing with up kicks, too, is you got to kick up. When you start kicking straight at your opponent, that's when Edward's going to pass because you're creating that angle. Up kick and bring your legs back in if you're going to up kick.
Well, what a round this has been for Folayang. It's going to end any second now, and Folayang is going to walk back to his corner well on top after 10 minutes of near domination.
Well, for those fans that are used to the 10-8 scoring system, if you were watching this in any other organization, this would probably be a 10-8 round because it was all Eduard Folayang all the time, all day, start bell to bell. You see here, he was just working some vicious ground and pound. He probably got in 50, 60 punches by my co-commentator Steve's count, and then he just launched a head kick that zeroed in like a homing device on the head of Latul, and then bam! Huge double leg. Takedown, submission attempts, double legs. This is the rebirth of Eduard Folayang, and Latul just hasn't really had an answer outside of being able to weather the storm.
Seconds out, please.
Well, I really can't translate what was being said there, but do something different was probably what was being told.
You know, Maya T there telling us the third round's up for grabs. Do something different. What can he do?
Yeah, it's tough because, you know, like, you see Eduard Folayang has been able to take Latul down. I think Latul really has to just start looking for the submissions if Edward's going to come in and look for those takedowns. Instead of trying to fight the takedown, look for that guillotine attempt. You know, it's tough, though, because... Oh, and a big right hand! It looked like Eduard may have slipped.
Yeah, Eduard smiled at him. And I think you're right, there may have been an element of slip in that.
This has been a great round. You know, Eduard Folayang's hallmark is just being an aggressive, entertaining striker. You'd have to take Eduard Folayang to a seminar for him to figure out how to have a boring fight.
So true. But he is on it tonight, isn't he? I mean, he's really, not that he ever comes to a fight not on it, but he really does seem as if he's willing to give everything on this occasion.
Well, and you know, to Latul's credit, he really has done a great job of just weathering the storm and showing how durable he is. I mean, that punch was a little off the mark. He really needs to get something going here. He just looks like he's waiting to set something up, but Eduard's got much more energy and the conditioning factor. Eduard's able to pop off 2, 3, 4 shots, and Latul's not able to find that rhythm that he really needs to get anything going. Steve, what would you do if you were in there right now in Latul's corner? What do you think, like, visualize, just seeing this from a fan's point of view?
Right and left hand, I'd try and get out of the way of that for a start.
That's probably great advice. Well, getting out of the way, is it?
Now the leg lock. No, it slipped away.
Yeah, that looked, it was hard to see. I actually looked down at the monitor for a half second there to see, but whatever it was, didn't make much of a difference because right back up to the feet. You know, if Eduard Folayang just tweaks his jiu-jitsu game a little more, he brings that up to like a strong blue-purple belt level. You know, he's going to be a dangerous, dangerous guy. He's got the striking prowess. His wrestling is probably the best wrestling at Team Lakai. And if he just gets his jiu-jitsu up to that level, there's not going to be a lot of guys that are going to be beating Folayang.
Well, I wonder now, with 2.5 minutes left, we just saw that spinning back kick that he likes so much. He likes that spinning back fist as well occasionally. But it was a little bit more pedestrian than it was in the first round. Obviously, the cardio's coming into effect now for Eduard, as it will do for Latul, but this could be perhaps a little bit of an opportunity as Eduard starts to tire. Still a huge uphill task for him. And Eduard coming forward, like throwing haymakers like that, are not going to make things any easier. Something we've seen a huge amount of from Folayang in the past, but the takedowns on this occasion have been varied and numerous. It's been a very complete performance from the Filipino, and they're really appreciating it here. Chants in unison from just behind me. He's a hero in this country.
Well, you know, the Filipino fight fans get behind all their fighters, and MMA is one of the sports here that is just exploding, not just here, but around the world. And the Filipinos really want to make their mark here. They got behind Manny Pacquiao in boxing, and then they've got guys like Anario Benario, Eduard Folayang, and several others that are coming up through the ranks here, making noise on the world stage. And with performances like this, not be long until everybody knows who Eduard Folayang is.
Inside the final half minute. Oh, and Folayang gets caught with a good counter right hand from Latul and a knee to the chin. But strangely, it knocked Latul over. He lost his balance. Folayang took it. And I fancy now.
That's a good way to tell you're tired. When you knee someone and you fall down.
You fall down.
But also, you know, your feet sweat just like every other part of your body. And back to the side action and ground to pound.
What a way to finish. Eduard Folayang has taken this fight the distance, and it will go to the judges' scorecards. But let's not kid ourselves. This is Folayang's fight. And pretty much everybody in this arena is happy about it. When you consider the beating that Team Lakai took the last time we were in Manila.
And how crazy was that? Big right hand that buckled Folayang a little bit. But Folayang right back in a pocket there. And I think it was mostly Folayang most of the way. Wouldn't you agree, Steve? I think he got better of this fight.
Yeah.
I can't see how the judges would score it any other way. You know, if this is an MMA competition under another rule set, this may even be a 10-8 round in here. But
perhaps even a couple of 10-8 rounds.
Yeah, I mean, you know, it depends on who's judging. But all in all, Folayang showed great improvement in his wrestling and got back on the winning track if this comes out the way we think it does, which would be just shocking if it doesn't.
Surely it will.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds, we go to the judges' scorecards, and all three judges see it for your winner via unanimous decision. Eduard Landslide Folayang!
Exactly as we suspected, this arena has just erupted. This is your co-main event of the evening, brought to you by Petron, fuel for everyone.
This is a really interesting stylistic matchup of two dynamic strikers, and both have knockout power in any punch they throw.
And this could really rattle your cage, this fight.
And this almost looks like a welterweight fighting a featherweight. Just a massive size difference, right? I mean, look at the back of Folayang.
You just know that Boku could go down a weight.
You know the craziest thing is, if I had to pick out the two coolest guys that were just like the most relaxed, always happy, would come change your tire if you got stranded on the side of the road, it would be these two guys.
And there's that right hand of Boku, just knocked Eduard back a step or two.
Boku, like I said, look at his footwork. He moves really well, shuffles his feet, doesn't cross them. He's got that light bouncing boxer light on his feet.
A constantly moving target.
He
said he likes a spin.
Oh,
I think he lost an eyebrow or two there, Kotetsu.
You don't see many wheel kicks that land in MMA, but when they do, good night, lights out, give me the check. Edson Barboza had a highlight reel. Spinning back knockout. Wheel kick.
Well, you're going to see two or three of these in every fight from Eduard. There's a big takedown. Oh, huge. Wow, he lifted him up almost above the cage and threw him down.
Oh, looks like Boku's trying to work a little bit of rubber guard here. Nice, holding that leg tight. Tight, mission control. This is a good position to stall your opponent out in. You have to be careful there, because sweat does become a factor, but you can look for a go-go plata from here if you get that. And it looks like he's looking for a go-go plata, but missed it. It's really tough to submit guys from the bottom if you're not super, super versed in guard. But, you know, Boku showing he's very aggressive here.
Incredibly supple as well, Boku, isn't he?
Yes.
36 years old, the Japanese man.
See, Edwards trying to work that right knee through to slice the guard. Step over, then try to pass.
Startling difference in body size. Folayang legs like tree trunks, biceps to die for. Boku, completely the opposite.
Good work by Boku. We haven't seen much of Boku off his back, nor have we seen much of Eduard with takedowns, especially that big flare double leg we just saw. You can tell that all the guys at Team Lakai, really, from Duck Yogan onto Folayang here, have worked on their wrestling. Yeah, all these things Boku's doing, these feints, these are really designed to see how his opponent, how Folayang's gonna react.
Yeah. And there's number two. I reckon we're in for at least a couple more. 1:30 left in the opening round.
You're watching a high-level, lethal chess game. Just a tremendous amount of respect shown by both guys for the other's striking attributes.
Neither of these two really back off in any way. You see lateral movement, but no more than a shuffle backwards from either man.
Well, the one thing that, see, look at the just how Boku keeps his weight right over his feet the whole time when he moves back.
Lin's out of range effortlessly and expertly, Boku.
Yeah, I think the only difference really is that, you know, in that range, Folayang does use a lot of kicks and will definitely headhunt, so that's a dangerous area for Boku, but just missed the takedown.
Just missed out on that.
I want to see how Eduard is off his back. Work out of the half guard. Oh, Folayang looking for the arm bar. It's not in deep enough, but showing how diverse he is.
Still got a hold of it.
That's pretty deep. It's hard to see from this side.
Saved by the bell, maybe?
Yeah, I don't think that was deep enough to really warrant Boku being in trouble, but I will give Folayang a tick mark in the aggression column for looking for those submissions off of his back.
Well, that opening round was a real taster of what we could expect in the remaining two. It's a great matchup stylistically.
And a beautiful double leg takedown. And some nice rubber guard work from Kotetsu Boku. Taking a page out of Shinya Aoki's book. You see right here, he's looking for a choke, trying to get his instep underneath the chin of Folayang. Folayang answered his own submission attempt here on an arm bar. You can see Kotetsu looks relaxed. Didn't look like that was too deep.
Seconds out, please.
Boku, who has been extravagantly bearded in the past.
He comes in all over the place. He got a Santa Claus beard, trims it down to the lumberjack.
He likes a tattoo as well.
That's right.
Second round then. Oh, good kick, and that connected.
So we're talking about that distance. Folayang lives in this range. Boku can't hit him, but he can get hit in the head with a foot. So far, from an aggression point of view, I've got Folayang up 2 check marks to 1 to Boku. Both guys look for submissions on the ground. Folayang with a nice takedown, a little more aggressive.
Just overextended himself a bit there with the punch that followed the kick, Folayang, and that's just because Boku is such a good mover. Oh, big right hand. It perhaps only scuffed Boku, but it was thrown with some ferocity. Inside leg kick from the Filipino. Boku still comes forward, but the inside of that leg is red. You can see under the shorts. And he's got a history of struggling with that, defending that. He had a tough time against Zorobabu Moreira, despite winning that eventually. And Vusile Colosa took a leaf out of Zorobabu's book by doing the same thing. We haven't seen so much of it from Eduard tonight, but that's a weapon he can use.
Boku's in on that front guillotine now. He's got the arm in. He may just choose to jump to guard here if he feels like it's a good calculated risk, and that's deep enough underneath the chin of Folayang.
Just wondered if he was looking to wrap both legs around Folayang for a moment there. He had the left leg over.
It's hard to see from this side if Folayang's in any type of danger, but it looks like his arm's free.
Nice little elbow from Folayang. And another heavy takedown attempt, but Boku got his foot down just in time to reduce the impact.
My goodness, that takedown he scored in the first round was just huge. Knee to the body, punches to the body. Folayang.
Oh, he's got the guillotine. That's in pretty deep, but you know, Boku put his arm in to relieve some pressure. Let's see if Boku's gonna be able to get up to his toes here to relieve a little more. Now, Edward doesn't have his hands clasped, so that's not gonna be as tight.
He's got that right leg up there to keep the body down so that he can get the leverage on the neck.
You know, Boku's fought guys like Hermes Franco who are really, really good jiu-jitsu exponents. And
what do you know?
He's been in these situations before.
What do you know? Eduard is cut above the eye. Not the biggest shock. Seven or so minutes left in this contest. It could have a story to tell in this battle. And Boku will see that. And you can bet he'll aim some punches up and around there.
You know, most of this fight's been contested, I would say, pretty equally, but most of it's been on the ground. Something you wouldn't have thought, two strikers.
Yeah, absolutely. And good shots from Boku on the ground there. I'm sure he'll be working on that eye.
Boku's doing a good job of staying busy.
Both men so well prepared. Again, Folayang tries the takedown at it. Again, Boku, though, just minimizes the impact by getting his foot down there. Unlike that very first episode in the first round, it was just brutal. 40 seconds left of the second. Knee to the head from Folayang. But Boku felt that. Exchanging little bothersome knees to the hip area.
Bothersome, that's how I would put it. It's definitely add up and can become exceptionally bothersome. You see the forehead of Folayang, that cut.
It's a mess now, isn't it?
Yeah, especially if blood gets in your eye, it becomes hard to see. I'm sure we're gonna clean it off here.
Just got out of range, Boku, as he tends to do actually very well.
Oh, big kick to the head.
It connected, that was effort number three, and it connected, and that'll score points, you can bet. But as Folayang retreats to his corner and has that blood wiped away.
See the submission attempt here by Folayang. You know, he didn't really have the guillotine in as deep as he wanted to. There's Gotetsu Boku, though, very active from Eduard Folayang's guard. But I've been really impressed with how Folayang has been able to secure these takedowns. Three takedowns to zip.
Whoa, that
Eduard
really
Folayang
connected so well, Jason. Around the right cheekbone of Boku.
See the welt over the eyebrow of Folayang there and that cut, like you made mention of earlier. He does seem to cut fairly easily.
Seconds out, please.
Lenny Hart rebuking the seconds, getting them out of there. We're all anxious to see this final 5 minutes. Fascinating 10 minutes we've had so far.
Final round!
Here we go.
If you just tuned into this fight, you would think that somebody messed up and put two different divisions together.
I really would.
People would be flagging Matt Hume saying, what are you doing? These guys cannot be the same weight class, but I was there for the weigh-in. They weighed in at the exact same...
Identical.
Exact same kgs, yep. But obviously, I don't think that Gotetsu is cutting anything besides maybe his hair.
He certainly has cut that. Left hand swinging from Folayang.
In aggression so far, Folayang's been moving forward and throwing a lot of head kicks. Boku, a little less aggressive, more of a counterpuncher. Damage Boku in the bigger column, up by one check mark. Again, damage, the second most important thing we look at behind who is the closest to getting the submission or knockout. You know, even though both Boku and Folayang did attempt a couple of submissions, neither one really had the opponent in danger. Danger being where I think, you know, you see your opponent's face and they're fighting hard to survive or they're thinking about tapping. But great effort, good aggression, both stand up and on the ground.
Three takedowns from Eduard has got away heavily in his favor, you'd think.
You ever seen someone who just swings for the fences more than these two?
Really?
Jab? What jab? Here's a right hand from Hades.
Who needs a rangefinder?
That's right.
Oh! Oh, wow! Folayang came in with a big foot there, and Boku just moved his head to the side, and it went crashing into the cage wall.
Folayang is starting to move up the meter there with those leg kicks on Boku.
If anything, the pace has heightened.
Nice leg kick again, kicked out the leg of Boku. See, now that leg kick is starting to add up. One or two more of those, and we're going to be pretty close here on the damage marker. You know, you mentioned that before. Boku really has never had an answer for that leg kick. We've seen in all of his fights. I mean, he's thrown a couple of counter right hands, but he eats a lot of damage on those legs.
They are exchanging bombs in there, Jason. 2.5 minutes left. What a cracker it's been. We all knew it would be.
You know, Boku's movement's getting a little slower. You see now he's crossing his feet when he walks. If you notice that, that's a sign of being a little more tired, which obviously, you know, you're 13 minutes into a fight, you're gonna be more tired. But Boku's now bouncing around like he was the first 5 minutes and shuffling his feet. These little indicators, if your opponent notices, can really make you smell blood like a lion in the safari of Africa.
2 minutes to go. Folayang ducks under the overhand right from Boku. And shuffles backwards. You've got to look at all angles when you face Folayang. The attack can come from the fists and the feet. That wushu-based style, so prominent in his stance and his style. Oh, there's a big punch. And it dropped Boku, and he follows up now directly above us in the cage. And Boku gives a little Ali shuffle in the city where Ali fought Frazier for the third time.
And you know, Boku is smart that he didn't stand up right away. He paused for a second because that kick came right over his head. Boku always keeps that front hand very low.
Just gonna say, it's very low. It could be a fatigue thing at this stage of the contest.
Well, I mean, it's a couple things. It's fatigue because your shoulders build up lactic acid, but it's also just a comfort factor of feeling like you're out of your opponent's striking range. That may not be the case, though.
Inside of that thigh, you can see the left leg Boku getting redder and redder as Folayang punishes him on the inside with the kicks. A fourth spinning attempt from Folayang and a takedown. And that could make a big difference to this contest if indeed there was any great doubt about it.
Very aggressive. Constantly looking for the finish.
We don't score round by round. It's an overall feeling for the fight, but Folayang has had a cracking final round here. And for my money, with 15 seconds left, that's probably edged it for him. And what a roar he will get if he does win this from his home crowd. Folayang and Boku in the final 10 seconds of this barn-burning contest. Again, the spinning back fist and the spinning back kick to finish it off. And what a way to end it from Folayang. I think he knows he's won it, and I think Boku knows that as well. Walking around with his hands on his hips as Eduard plays to the camera. What a great contest.
That was a great fight. You know, there was some great back and forth action from Boku and from Folayang. Aggression, though, I've given Boku one check in that column, and really Folayang four checks, because he's been moving forward a lot, throwing a lot of combinations at Boku. Whether they've been landing or not is a different story. And that goes more into the striking aspect, but between shooting the takedowns, engaging the fight, you see here, Eduard Folayang has four takedowns. Kotetsu Boku didn't get any. Ground control was very close back and forth. Striking superiority gave one check mark to Folayang. And then damage,
very, very close. One for Boku because of the eye damage, and then also one for Folayang.
So Folayang for you?
So far, I'm going with Folayang.
I'll go with him too. Here's Anthony Sultan.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds, we go to the judges' scorecards. And all three judges see it for your winner via unanimous decision. From the red corner, Eduard Landslide Folayang.
Ready? Fight!
This is quite a match brought to you by Under Armour. Folayang in the red shorts, Yamada in the blue.
Interesting style by Yamada.
Yeah.
He's very relaxed, just kind of looking like he's kind of playing a video game. He's
That is an odd style, unique, I would say. Very upright, isn't he, from waist up.
His hands are nice, they're just kind of moving around. You know, Yamada was a big prospect in Japan when he's coming out of high school. And this is just his first time. He's fought in some big organizations over there in Japan.
Look at the difference in stance. Folayang leaning forward from the waist, Yamada straight up. Like he's got a rod in his spine there. I'm sure it works for him.
The hand movement is definitely unconventional, and that's kind of where his nickname kind of comes from, is that creative sort of style.
Big left hand from Yamada. As we say, a very big hello to our friends watching on Astro Super Sport in Malaysia. Hope you're enjoying the fight tonight so far. This one very high level in the lightweight division. Folayang just employed a spinning back kick there. He likes that a lot. If you get the chance, you'll see a lot more spinning back fists and back kicks. We talked earlier in the evening about how that can expose you. But Folayang loves it, and he'll take that opportunity whenever he can.
Yeah, the wushu style out of Team Lakai is so unique, and it's hard to emulate in training. But, I mean, with Yamada's unique style as well, both these guys are coming out very unorthodox. It's hard to predict really what they're going to be doing.
Punishing inside leg kick from Folayang, making contact with the inner right thigh of Yamada. Both of these men in tremendous shape.
Yamada's dropping his hands every so often. If Folayang can drop a big kick to the head or strike, he could put this away. And Folayang's known for that explosive style. It comes out of nowhere with the side kicks, the strikes, coming from the hands as well.
Folayang will be in tremendous. There's another spinning back kick there, just to the waist. He'll be in tremendous shape. That altitude training means that all of the Lakai fighters always come very well prepared. Nice one too there from Eduard.
Just barely missing with that big right hand. Mana seems very relaxed, very composed.
1-2 to the body there from Folayang. Not a combination you see so very often. Leaves your head hanging a little bit, but if you've got quick hands like Eduard, you can often get in and out without receiving too much damage. Strong legs Folayang has. You don't want to be kicked by those.
Nice body shot by Folayang.
Yamada gets that kick up nice and high and very quickly, doesn't he? A couple of times he's got it up there to head level in the blink of an eye.
Nice little inside leg kick and follows it up with that big right hand. And he's just barely missing by a very narrow margin with that big bomb of a right hand he's throwing.
This Malaysian crowd, they've been noisy all evening, but you could hear a pin drop now. Oh, big right hand from Folayang.
He landed at that time. Yamada didn't like that and immediately goes in for the tie-up. Good takedown defense by Folayang. That opened up Yamada a bit there on the bridge of his nose.
This crowd absolutely enthralled by this contest. They've been on their feet from start up to this point where we've got 45 seconds left. And there's a big cut in between the eyes. The Japanese fighter, and he goes down to a heavy blow.
He jumped right into a stiff jab by Folayang.
trying to prevent Folayang jumping on top and perhaps unleashing some ground and pound.
30 seconds left.
He'll be aware that he's cut. Half a minute left before he gets some attention from his corner men. And Edward says, stand up. I don't like that. Let's get back on our feet where I've already caused quite a bit of damage. Yamada blinking hard now. Will he see out the remaining 10 seconds of this round? Looks like he will.
Nice takedown defense by the Filipino as he sprawls out from the takedown. It looked like Yamada was going to get it, but he lands an outside trip there to end up.
Having said, Mitch, that Folayang was vulnerable to cuts, it's the Japanese man who goes back to his corner who needs attention.
Yeah, there's that spinning attack shown by Folayang, but then as he steps away, there's a nice little kind of a knee on the exit. He likes that spinning attack. There's that inside leg kick, and then that overhand left came out of nowhere. There's that jab that Yamada just kind of stumbled into. Let's jump to Rich Franklin and see how he has it so far.
Well, I'll tell you, Yamada started this round aggressive at the beginning, pushed against the cage, was really working for some position. But once they broke, at about the 3 to 3.5 minute mark left of the round, Folayang just started taking off, landing those low kicks, the inside low kicks, and started getting really, really aggressive with his striking. Became very superior with the striking. Landed the knockdown, a little bit of damage with those hands. So at this point in time, he's just kind of started running through those stand-up categories and running with this decision. If the fight was stopped here, Folayang would definitely have his hands down.
Bad news for Yamada, given that this fight has been in the stand-up pretty much all the time, that he hasn't registered at all in terms of striking there from Rich.
Ready?
So big round for Eduard Folayang. And the Japanese man not only has to cope with that momentum, but also that cut. I think it's on the inside of the right eye. Just underneath the eyebrow there. Blood looks to have been staunched for the moment. Let's see how quickly Eduard can focus on that, if indeed he does at all.
See, the awkward hand movement of Yamada is not really distracting Folayang. He's actually enabling him to open up some big shots, and he's leaving himself really exposed to the explosive hands of Folayang.
With the hands low and that big upright stance, that head's quite a big target.
Yeah, and Yamada's got about 5 centimeters in height, so it puts him at a greater disadvantage, especially having his chin up in the air like this.
Tree trunks for legs, Eduard Folayang, isn't he? So strong.
Inside leg kick just almost took the wheels out from under Yamada as he shot him for the takedown there and
looks
up on his
some
back.
Discomfort. What can he do? It's almost desperation time there. He scrambled up very quickly.
Hold his horse. Folayang is demonstrating some really good takedown defense. As I say that, Yamada puts him onto his back and ends up in side control. Nice scramble by Folayang, but it enables Yamada to possibly get the back. Folayang's doing the right thing by trying to turn his back to the cage.
There's enough sweat, perspiration, and water on their bodies now to make purchase a little bit more difficult than it was in the first round. And I think Yamada had a tough time just holding on to that slippery body that Edward has now developed.
Yeah, if any of our viewers have had like gone fishing and they've tried to grab onto a fish out of the water, that is pretty much the feeling when you're grappling at this time in the fight.
That's a big fish, the Filipino. Big fish to hold on to. You can see this new revolutionary way of making weights that takes the danger away for these fighters, brings these two into the cage in tremendous condition. Folayang looking huge there. In particular, Yamada is a taller man. Can't afford to bulk up quite as much as Edward has. But I've never seen Edward look this big, this strong before. Another spinning back kick. Didn't connect this time.
Yeah, that time he kind of set it up pretty dramatically. Like he was stepping forward on the lead leg a little bit to the outside. Yeah. And it just kind of showed Yamada that, yeah, here it comes. And he was easy to evade it.
That's part of the whole thing, is it's such a production, the whole thing, that it can be telegraphed. It can expose you once you've come all the way around. It's a dangerous, dangerous maneuver, but you won't see any shortage of that from Edward. Oh, 1-2, big speed there. Again, going down to the body. We've seen that twice now.
Yeah, he's going high with the jab, kind of brings Yamada's hands up.
My goodness me, that's swinging right. Gave the Japanese man a bit of a haircut. Had it been a couple of inches lower, untold damage could have been wrought. Now, the last time we saw this, Eduard asked him to stand up. I wouldn't be surprised if he does the same any second now.
See, now, Folayang can actually throw some leg kicks and really do some damage to the legs of Yamada. It'll actually help him during these stand-up exchanges.
It's a great bout, this. Haven't been able to take our eyes off it for a second, and these fans at Stadium Nagara, absolutely enthralled.
He is just beating up the inside leg. That right leg of Yamada is taking a beating. And every time he lands it...
Good right hand there from Yamada. He landed. Right on the top of Edward's forehead.
See, Folayang likes to go up high with that jab, come down low to the body, really mixing up the areas, attacking the legs.
A couple of times Yamada skipped into that like scissor kick attempt, but he's not unleashed it yet. He's pulled out because it's so heavily telegraphed.
30 seconds left in the second round.
Oh, right hand, very nice one. It was an overhand right from Yamada. Just cuffed Eduard around the jaw. No real damage done as we approach the end of the second round.
Yamada again going for that takedown. Folayang gets easily, shrugs it off, ends up on top. I like how he throws the legs aside and then sneaks around for that technical ground kick.
There it is again, just as you said it, on the bell. 10 minutes of this 15-minute contest done. We'll get Rich's view on who's ahead at this stage. But first of all, let's just take a look at some of the highlights from this action-packed fight that we've seen so far.
There's that right hand that Folayang's been landing pretty much all night. Here he is stopping the takedown. Here's that outside trip that Folayang made me look bad as I'm commenting on it. He drags him to the ground and ends up on top position. And there's some of those hand exchanges that have really been the kind of the highlight of the night, as these two trade blows on their feet. So far, at this point in the round, how does Rich see it?
Well, I'll tell you, that was not an overly aggressive round, so there's not much change there. Yamada earned a takedown, so he kind of evened up that category, but Folayang is still just kind of, he's running away a bit more with the striking superiority, did a little bit more damage in that round, so in my opinion, he's just furthered his lead on the scorecards, and if the fight was stopped here, still in the favor of Folayang.
5 minutes to go. We view the fight in its entirety, not round by round. So don't view this as Eduard being up by 2 rounds to nothing.
Ready?
That's not the case. It's exactly as Rich explained it from his point of view. We don't know how the judges are seeing this, but I think there's every chance that they're pretty well aligned with Rich. This fight brought to you by Under Armour. Folayang in the red, Yamada in the blue.
Both these fighters looking real fresh to start this third round, which has got to be due to the no weight cut and, you know, just the optimum performance level of both of our fighters. Nice pressure by Folayang. He's kind of cutting off the cage.
Yeah.
As Yamada moves one way, Folayang just kind of slides over and kind of cuts him off.
Fourth time we've been in this situation, and the fourth time Edward says, no, I'd rather we stand up, thank you.
Yeah, and the crowd wants to see the stand up too.
He telegraphs that kick an awful lot, doesn't he? He takes a step back. It's easy for Edward to step out of range as long as the cage wall isn't directly behind him.
That looked like he was trying for a free kick in football. He just kind of set that up and he ran into it.
Meanwhile, the spinning back kick from Edward again. We've seen a couple of decent finishes already this evening. Eustaquio, Nicholas Lee, Christian Lee. My apologies, I keep calling him Christian, don't I? Will we see a similar finish? The bad lad finish of the night is to be awarded, and Eduard will want every piece of that he can get. Christian Lee, though, so impressive. Young man with a huge future. The future for Eduard Folayang, well, in many ways, it's now. This is a big opponent for him to beat if he can manage it tonight. And that was a heavy right hand that stopped Yamada's advance forward in his tracks.
Yeah, Folayang's looking really good. He's able to stop a lot of the takedowns, you know, shown by Yamada. You can see it right here as he gets dragged to the ground. Every time I say that, he gets taken down, so I'm just going to stop saying that.
I think he likes you talking about that now.
As Yamada ends up on top. And this is really where Yamada's tried to get the fight the entire time. So let's see what he can do by having Folayang on his back.
Well, this is the third and final round. 2:36 left. He's got a lot to do. But Eduard bringing him so close, tying up those arms, giving Yamada very little choice, very little scope to achieve anything effective. Draws that knee way back before landing it on the inner thigh of the Filipino.
Yamada's trying to slide that knee in between the legs of Folayang, which is going to attempt to pass the guard of Folayang here, but Yamada's really not doing anything with this position. He's not trying to break the guard. He's not trying to advance it much. Folayang's actually trying to work his way back up to attempt a possible submission here.
You might see some blood on Folayang's body, but I don't think that's coming from Eduard. I think that's coming from Yamada.
See, you can see how in the guard position, Yamada's trying to swing that leg over, which is more of an aggressive sort of guard pass. He's trying to get by. Now he's actually in half guard now. Folayang's got that knee across his belly, and that prevents him from really going anywhere.
1.5 minutes left. You'd fancy that it's Folayang who's looking just to consolidate, just to keep things stable.
But you gotta be active. You can't just hang out there in this position. You gotta consistently be looking to finish the fight at all times. With once champions aggressive, they reward people in the scoring factor for trying to finish the fight.
Stop.
See, Lampitin, he doesn't like it. He wants to get these guys up. You've got to always try to move forward and finish the fight at all times.
With applause from the fans here at Stadium Nagara. Was that a questionable stand-up, Rich Franklin, or was that something that you would applaud?
Not in my opinion. I believe it was a great stand-up. Yamada's just sitting in his guard, and what we refer to as body-body-head strikes, he's not going to finish the fight that way. It's just body-body-head. It's not doing anything, and right. At some point in time, you have to put the fight in a position where somebody is looking for a stoppage, and that's what a stand-up.
30 seconds then. Lenny Hart tells everybody that that's where we are in this fight. We've had 14 and a half minutes. There was a knee to the body there from Yamada, but Folayang has 20 seconds left to bring this one to a close. And there's the signature spinning back kick from him. Didn't connect in any kind of effective way. Final 10 seconds. And are we about to say it for the umpteenth time in his career? Is he on the cusp of a tilt at the title? Eduard Folayang, he's done it again, I think. Yamada sinks to his haunches. Yamada wanders to his corner. Very, very energetic and enthralling 15 minutes we've seen. You've seen there how much it's taken out of the Japanese man on his knees. But this was fun to watch.
Yeah, you can see there that Yamada was actually successful in the takedown as he sucked in that leg. Here, not so much, as Folayang easily sprawls away and adds a nice little knee as they try to get back up. It was a very entertaining fight, a lot of high-level MMA. Rich, how do we have it?
Well, I'll tell you, I give Yamada credit. He stayed aggressive the whole time looking for that takedown. Although he wasn't really effective with it, he didn't do much in that round other than get the takedown. And when he had the takedown, the ground and pound didn't really mount to much. Once they got back to the feet, Folayang, he continued with the striking superiority and actually continued to mount up some damage, specifically with that right hand that he landed. And the knee to the body, I think, both hurt Yamada. So it just furthered the scoring in his category. This should be all Folayang.
To present the medal for this fight, we have Under Armour Southeast Asia's Chief Marketing Officer, Mr. Adrian Chai. Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds, we go to the judges' scorecards. And all three judges see it for your winner via unanimous decision. From the blue corner, Eduard Folayang!
And this fight is brought to you by the Venetian Macau. They touch gloves in the center of the cage. Both fighters coming out in the orthodox stance. Adrian Pang with a nice high guard.
Adrian Pong was so excited for this fight because he knew that Eduard would stand there and trade with him. So he trained specifically for this, like this odd, unique style that Folayang brings to the cage.
As is the case with most Team Lakai fighters, styles his game based on wushu. So fluid kicks and fist attacks, very seamless transition from one to the other.
Looks very stoic. He's just taking the leg kicks, not really even flinching. Moving around, waiting to unload that giant right hand of his.
Much of Eduard's work from distance will come from those legs.
Good. He's got to use those kicks. He's got to use those push kicks to keep Pong away from the punching range.
You guys around the world, potentially about a billion of you in 118 countries, can't fail to have enjoyed the entertainment so far tonight. It could get even better. These two are ferocious warriors, and that was a beautiful second kick, wasn't it?
Beautiful cut right into the neck of Pang. Spin to attack with his kick. Pong steps in for a big right hand.
Right hand over the top there from Adrian Pong.
Clip the temple right on the side of the head, and that's such a dangerous fight to, or dangerous spot to catch shots because it sets your equilibrium off.
What's the advantage of those underhooks that Adrian Pong has there, Mitch? What can he achieve with those? Just one of them left in now.
When you have an underhook, you have more control over that person's side, and you can really use it to control your opponent a lot better. But when they have kind of a 50-50 position, it's nullified on both sides.
Oh, the guillotine now from Pang.
Nice little roll and the headlock.
He's still in there, still in a bit of trouble. If he can wrench that, he needs to lift that body up to get torque on the throat. Trying to just disable him, pulling his legs away.
Sacrifice throw, fall as he went in there for a deep into the choke. He ends up on bottom now. Let's see what Adrian Pang can do as he tries to work back up to the standing position. Nice roll by Eduard Folayang. Beautiful hip toss.
On their feet and applauding that move from Eduard Folayang. And this from a wushu specialist, Mitch.
Beautiful.
There's a true mixed martial artist.
Wrestling, judo, we're seeing a whole new Team Lakai right now. Good control, now he's inside control. Now he's starting to knee the body, soften Adrian up a little bit. Adrian's kind of turn onto his side and start moving away so he can create some space here. But he seems okay. He seems perfectly content to just sit there in the side mount position.
When you think over the years, the Team Lakai fighters have been in with some tremendous BJJ exponents. Jehe Eustaquio in with Adriano Moraes. Kevin Belingon in with Bibiano Fernandez. Team Lakai have picked up a trick or two, and they've needed to adapt.
These guys train absolutely all out. They're just such an impressive group of athletes, and I think most of them have a degree in criminology, which means at some point, all these Team Lakai fighters are gonna be sort of the police force in Baguio.
That's an end to crime in Baguio?
I think that's a movie that I need to make very soon.
Pong gets tossed onto his back.
Good control shown by Folayang right here.
A glorious crowd here at the Venetian Macau, loving this entertainment.
You can see Aoki over here in the corner looking very intently at one of his possible future challenges in the cage right now.
Whoever wins this is in a very prominent position to challenge Shinya Aoki for his lightweight belt.
Eduard's come so close so many times to a shot at championship gold. This could be it if he brings his best foot forward here tonight.
To put that guillotine in, if he can just pull it forward, up and forward. Pong looks in a little bit of distress, but he's on his haunches.
I mean, you gotta have tremendous strength from this position to submit your opponent or to choke out your opponent with no hooks in or no guard from the guard position or even half guard.
Slighting knee attack to the thigh. Right hand from Eduard as he just pulled out of that move. And Pong looks totally at ease with everything that's just happened. Oh,
Steve, I am in shock right now. I thought the referee to this, there's that front side kick. We got to take a look at the finish there of that round. There's some of the ground and pound from Pang earlier. There's that beautiful hip toss by Folayang earlier in the round. But here it is. There's that spinning back miss. Blocks him, and then he catches him with a right roundhouse kick. I think that was after the bell.
I don't know where the bell came, before the kick, after the kick, after the punch. I did not hear it. The crowd reacted so loudly.
Iron chin of Adrian Pang right there to get dropped with the spinning back fist.
And I've never seen him drop it. He throws that in every fight, but I've never seen him drop anyone with it.
Wow, that
just caught him absolutely flush, didn't it? Tremendous exhibition of how to deliver that spinning back fist. And that won't be the last one you see in this contest either. His signature move, and it was delivered with perfection.
Beautiful first round shown there. I think this entire crowd is on their feet right now. Very heavy on his feet. He's not really light.
But that's his style, isn't it?
Yeah, he just marches, stomps forward, throws big strikes. Edwards working that inside leg kick now. He's got the right game plan. He's staying away. He see how he's staying out of punching range, and he's staying inside his kicking range. So he can still land big kicks, but he's staying around or staying away from those devastating right hands
and
of Adrian Pang.
Adrian teasing him a bit, just dropped his hands for a second, saying, come on, then come inside. Come and rumble with me. And there he is again, doing exactly the same thing.
He knows he has an iron chin, but after that spinning back
fist, this time I think he got his glove up and just parried it. It's like Adrian Pang is a rock.
He's taking that inside leg kick a lot. You know, look at that, he's just beating up that leg. I think that one could have been a little high there.
Oh, right hand, and I thought for a second it had dropped for Folayang. But he just popped back up.
19.
Guillotine.
And he's got the guard in. He's got to fight those hands. Folayang's got to fight those hands, but he might pop his head out.
I think he might just manage to squeeze it. He's very alert to it. He's got his right hand that's doing all he can to free him of that position.
You never want to just try to pull your head out. He's got to fight the hands. He's got to fight the hands. Get his head down onto the mat.
He's done it. He's done it. And listen to the roar from the crowd here. This is the noisiest crowd I've experienced at a one championship event, and they are absolutely loving this.
Watch out!
Some strikes from the bottom position by Pang. Edward Folayang not trying to pass the guard, just comfortable to sit inside Adrian's guard and drop
bombs. Eduard, your fingers,
from
watch
there.
Out!
Fun 88 fight of the night. Let's reset the whole thing and just hold off for a while.
I think we might be a fun 88 event of the night, because this is one of the most action-packed events we've ever had at one championship. And we've had some killer events. Look at how light Edward still looks. He's got a bounce in his step. There he is again.
Spinning elbow this time. He's gone with fist, foot, and now elbow. And Pang still stands in front of him, asking him to give him some more.
Arnold Schwarzenegger-esque as the Terminator, Adrian Pang, just marches forward.
Has his hand on the SM. Come on, man. Let's see some more. And you will see some more from Edward.
You don't want to tempt fate. Some of these kicks are landing with tremendous power from Folayang.
Oh, that was a big, solid ramrod right. He's fired it up with a kick. Pang can't take this all night, surely.
His head is filled with concrete along with his hands, and he has taken some big shots here from Folayang.
Well, in terms of what the judges may be thinking, with a minute and a half left in the second, perhaps Folayang just managing to catch their eye.
Man, we might need to change Landslide's. Edward Folayang's nickname from Landslide to Helicopter, because this guy is about to take off, throwing so many spinning attacks.
I mean, he's doing everything that catches the judge's eye.
It's like the Filipino Bali song, the butterfly, the knife that people spin around.
you have great admiration that Adrian is taking this punishment, but he's got to start dealing out a little bit more. Otherwise, this might just go adrift of him. 50 seconds left in the second.
Good hand fighting, but you can see they're trying to fight for position here. Really intricate battle that's going on inside there. Trying to control the other person's wrist, but on the exit.
Bloodied the nose of Adrian Pung with that.
Spins with the elbow.
And they are landing absolutely flush. And a straight right followed up there. Missed with that left. Pung is taking some tremendous punishment. Try it again, Edward. Missed that time.
Big attack shown by, I mean, what is, I mean, Folayang's got to be wondering, what do I have to do to put this guy down?
I can't see it happening, to be honest. As you said, there's cement in that body. He just keeps coming forward.
Time!
Wow, what a, man, this is a tremendous arsenal of attacks coming from Folayang. But just the chin of Adrian Pung is on display here. There he is. Kind of caught. That one didn't land fully flush. Here's the attempted guillotine by Pang as Edward pops his head out. Here's a beautiful, another spinning back fist attempted there. There's another spinning heel kick landed. The wheel kicks keep coming from Folayang, the Bali Song of MMA.
Wow. What an offense from Eduard Folayang. I don't think we've seen it quite as potent as this before. And he's facing a man who seems to just be able to take it. It's a relentless barrage to the Filipino. 5 minutes left.
Now he's starting to keep his hands up though, so he's deflecting a lot of these attacks. But he's not really engaging in the offense of his own. So right now, Edward is running away from this fight.
But let's just hop back to that guillotine move, where it looked for a moment there as if Edward might be vulnerable. And that surely is what Adrian has to aim for.
All right, fighters,
because
ready?
At distance, ready? He's not achieving what he set out to.
Adrian's still dangerous. He still has that right hand that at any time can come out of nowhere and put his opponent to sleep. So he's still very dangerous right now. So Edward has to keep his wits about him.
He takes more huge right now. Still very much in this. He's still got his wits about it, no question. But my goodness, he was dropped with a heavy bombardment there.
Now he's working from the half guard. Let's see if he can take advantage of this, pass the half guard, get in the mount, and work from a more dominant position. But Adrian's kind of got almost a lockdown position there. He's interlaced the half guard, so he can't really get his foot out anywhere.
Edward's forearm all the while on Adrian's throat or face, keeping that head pinned down. He'll be looking to do it again now that Adrian's just pulled himself up slightly with those abdominal muscles.
And the chin of Adrian Pang is very impressive, but the attacks that, you know, Folayang has landed right now. I mean, he's just developed serious power that he's landing right now. As he, oh, nice sweep and reversal for Pang to end up on top.
Eduard looks at his corner and listens to the instruction.
Adrian's still dangerous. He's so strong and he's so experienced that he can kind of maintain and use this cardio when he needs to.
That
nice
was
elbow
a
right
heavy,
there.
Heavy elbow and forearm. Folayang took big blows there. Can Adrian turn this around? Another elbow grazes the head of the Filipino.
Attempting kind of a can opener there as he was pulling on the head.
This is good work from Adrian. And Edward.
Adrian's still in this. You know, he's a 15-year veteran, like we said. He's been there, he's seen it all.
Tremendous forearm work.
I think most people would be, it would have been a night a long time ago for a lot of individuals, but Adrian Pang is no ordinary individual.
Oh, another big bruising left elbow.
If he can control this position right here and really sort of dominate from this, from the half guard position and land some significant ground and pound, I mean, the fight's still up in the, I mean, Eduard has really definitely got a big lead right now, but Adrian's landing some big shots and doing a lot of damage.
Just over halfway through the final round here, 2:20 left. And there's that elbow again. The biggest weapon of this third round for Adrian Pan.
There's Folayang's trying to go for a Kimura here. He can use this to sweep. It's kind of hard to submit it because he's not really in the right position, yeah, but he could use this to reverse the position. But it also stops him from really hitting him with that left hand.
For it though, isn't he?
Yeah, it's there, you know, he could, you know, but Adrian's so strong. It's gonna be hard to sweep him. His base is so stable.
100 seconds left.
Watch out, the last one.
He abandoned go of it. He's let go of it.
Goes back to it. Adrian pops out of that.
What it means is he's going to take more punishment from that Adrian Pan forearm.
Folayang did the right thing. He got the underhook, started to move onto his side, but Adrian, the veteran that he is, stepped over and went back into half guard to keep Folayang in the bottom position. Very intelligent move by Adrian.
Coming up to a minute left of this thrilling fight that has seen this arena erupt at times.
See Folayang trying for a butterfly sweep. That's beautiful. A kind of a scissor sweep there. Pressure with that shoulder now. See how he's pushing his chin to go to the opposite way? That just kind of locks Folayang into that position, kind of lets go of it now. Not really applying that same pressure. You can see the right arm there of Folayang. If he gets it underneath, he's going to have the underhook.
Now Eduard has the front. Now he slips away.
A little too high up on the head there.
15 seconds.
Folayang's threatening attacks and sweeping. He's trying to advance his position.
Couple of good right hands from the Australian. Is it too little, too late though? Looks as if it will be. What a fight. Ooh. Just looking around behind me, everybody breaking into applause on their feet. Great appreciation for these two. And of course, the mutual respect that is virtually compulsory in this sport. What a tribute to these two fighters and their camps that they could show such a high level of cardio and offense.
Let's take a look at some of this action. There's that there's that incredible attack. That there, there's that spinning back fist, that drop pang, and then there's the roundhouse at the end of the round.
Just
there.
Seemed impervious to it, didn't he?
There's the spinning attacks that Folayang was throwing all night. There's that big right hand.
That was the punch of the night.
Put him down. Being the veteran that he is, he was able to compose himself, stop the ground and pound attack, stall him enough, and move on.
So come on, who's won it?
I mean, you got to give the damage and the significant strikes landed by Folayang. At this point, I give the fight to Folayang.
I'm with you. It doesn't matter, though. What matters is this.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds, we go to the judges' scorecards. And all three judges, see it for your winner via unanimous decision. Eduard the Landslide Folayang!
Great respect from Adrian Pang, immediately broke into applause.
Ready, one championship go at the Singapore Indoor Stadium. Great crowd, very noisy. This is what they came for. Bright hands from Folayang early on, wanting to land those big punches as soon as he can before Aoki can get to grips with him.
Immediately, Aoki comes open-handed, no strikes thrown, gets into the clinch, and it is no surprise that he wants this fight as quickly as he can to the ground.
Strong man Folayang, tough to get into the ground. He'll rely on technique, just as he did there. Now, how good is Folayang's submission defense? And can he get back onto his feet where he'll be more dangerous?
Aoki is so strong from these positions. Once he gets those hands on you, it's just like he has clasp, like he's just magnetized to your body. He keeps such tight pressure in every inch that he slides his body that he easily passes into side control, laces the hands. He's got deceptively long limbs. He's got a great ridge, and he easily slides around. Nice, but he jumps onto the back of Folayang. They're dry, too. There's no sweat on the body, so it's a lot harder to slip out of these positions. Folayang is very explosive. He likes to burst into positions, but Aoki's dry, so he's clinging onto the back like a koala bear.
They're directly above us here at cage side. Good strength from Aoki.
Armbar, possible armbar here. It looks like he's going for it. It looks like he's setting up a Kimura now. Taking the back, he uses it to hold on to the position. Now he's got the back and the body triangle.
Folayang will have trained for these kind of positions intensively over the past few weeks.
Yeah, but you just don't know if he has the caliber of grappler out there in Baguio like Shinya Aoki.
I think it's inevitable that he doesn't have it. This is the real thing. This is the biggest test for him.
And even if he does have great grapplers in his camp, they're not going to be able to emulate the style that Aoki has. He's so unique, he's so versatile, and he's so different, he's so creative. Nobody in the world is like Shinya Aoki.
This fight being beamed to 118 countries around the world. Tremendous level of interest in this contest. The flagship of one championship in many ways, Shinya Aoki. Mitch, you've fought and grappled with, trained with Shinya Aoki before. You haven't fought him as such, but you've trained with him so many hours. Just how tough is it?
Yeah, Steve, I've spent hours on the mat with this guy, and I don't last very long. I don't last as Edward's doing a great job, and he's able to slide out.
And he's back on his feet, and that's where
impressive.
He wants to be. Great impetus for Folayang fans now. What can he do with this opportunity?
That's a victory all unto itself, but now he's going to have to be very careful. Ooh, he jumps into a nice little knee there. He should have circled around and created more space because Aoki immediately goes to the clinch. He's got those hips laced up, so Folayang really can't go anywhere, and he uses a beautiful body lock trip takedown. And now Folayang's up against the cage.
He's okay.
1 minute 30 left of this opening round. Most of it has been on the deck with Aoki in charge. Elbow to the head of Folayang.
Folayang was able to get back into guard, a better position for him. Not as much danger, pushes off.
Great strength again from the Filipino.
Look how tight he immediately magnetizes himself to Folayang, letting him go nowhere.
Thrives on the contact, the Japanese fighter, doesn't he? Doesn't want any space between you and him.
Folayang's doing a good job. He's got to break this body lock. You don't want to let your opponent get double underhooks and get that tight body lock, because Shinya's probably going to end up going to a trip here and drag Folayang back down to the mat. You can see him trying to pick him up, but Folayang maintain a good base.
Five rounds this one, potentially. Don't forget, championship contest.
Judges will score the bout in its entirety, and
not round by round. We'll go to Rich Franklin when this one's done to get his thoughts on the first 5 minutes.
Good balance shown by Folayang because he went for that outside trip there. And Folayang was able to maintain his balance and stay on his feet. And he actually looks like he's going to get out of the first round after some very dangerous. The entire hush has fallen over the Singapore Indoor Stadium as this packed crowd is just waiting for
a good trip.
Beautifully timed. Right as Folayang was throwing that knee, Aoki swept that foot out and just scored with another takedown. We can see here's Aoki threatening with a possible Kimura, was able to maintain that position with the Kimura using those long legs to secure the back and just jump on there with that body triangle. It's probably pretty evident how this round has been scored, but let's go to Rich Franklin, just get his opinion on what's happening so far.
Yeah, obviously this fight is all about the ground control. Aoki is taking control with the takedowns. He's controlling Folayang on the ground, but Folayang has showed some glimpses, and this is what I talked about before the fight. He's very unorthodox. He works himself out of weird positions.
which is a very difficult thing to do against a guy like Aoki. After all, you've had him on top of you and you know what it's like. So it's going to be interesting because Aoki has been pressure in the first round, and I wonder if that's going to actually affect his gas tank at all. And you know, Folayang, he'll stay unorthodox the whole fight, and we're going to see if that actually poses some problems in the later rounds. At this point, if the fight was stopped, obviously Aoki.
Fight!
We're only 1/5 of the way through this contest as scheduled, though. And those Baguio trainers training at altitude are very, very fit. Cardio is a big deal for them.
Looks like a kick was the first strike that Aoki has thrown this entire fight.
Folayang trying to confuse with movement laterally, side to side, changing direction constantly.
That's what he needs to do, Steve. That's what he needs to do.
Really let go with that kick, and there was the familiar spinning back fist. Didn't connect.
He can't help it. He's put himself into a dangerous position when he spins by giving the back to Aoki like that. But he says he can't help it. It's just something that naturally happens. He loves the spinning attacks. That's good. That's good. Looked like it was a possible headbutt to the chin there. Yuji Shimada is warning Folayang about it.
Whenever Aoki shoots for the takedown, he's got to be careful of knees and all sorts of things coming at him because Folayang will have trained for that. Land those blows when you can.
Good movement. Aoki's trying to pressure Folayang up against the cage. Folayang's got to start moving. He can't let him get that close.
He's an expert at just cutting you off, isn't he, Aoki?
He's cutting beautiful corners. Nice defense there from Eduard as he throws off the double leg attempt from Aoki.
Great strength from the Filipino to do that. He's got tree trunk legs, as so many of the fighters in Baguio do. Training in those hills, tremendous strength in the lower limbs. That was just, everything was thrown into that. It didn't land, but it nearly knocked Aoki over just with the draft.
I'm liking the lateral movement of Folayang. He's moving really well on his feet. He's just not putting any strikes behind it, so he's not scoring. He's not hurting Aoki, except with these big, scary strikes, which I think I can kind of feel the wind from over here. Oh, nice little knee, but again, he gives himself into the takedown.
It was a very ambitious effort, wasn't it, from Eduard? He was always going to expose himself if it didn't pay off.
High-risk move with huge payoff capabilities, but now he's on the mat with one of the world's greatest.
Approaching the midway point in the second round. One championship, lightweight title on the line. The champion in the white shorts, the challenger in the red.
Aoki's doing the right thing. He's pushing him up against the cage, dropping him with those elbows. He's not only scoring points, but he's also softening up Eduard. Folayang's trying to create some kind of space. And that's exactly what he's able to do.
Oh, but he's done well.
Immediately latches onto him.
Back on his feet, Folayang, but still not out of trouble.
It's better than where he was. So that's improvement.
Knees to the body from the Filipino. Ideally, he wants space between the two of them so that he can attack with legs and punches, but these knees to the body will be punishing.
Nice knees from Folayang. He scored a bit there and was able to break away. These might be moral victories for Folayang, but I don't know if the judges score on survival.
Five rounds, it's a marathon, not a sprint. Folayang knows that if he can just keep surviving, the chances will come.
You can see Aoki's not expending any energy. He's completely relaxed into every single one of these positions that he gets into, and Folayang's not landing any strikes that are doing any significant damage to Aoki yet.
Contrastingly, in the stand-up, Folayang expending a lot of energy, lots of lateral movement.
That was a nice little lower leg kick there thrown by Folayang. Aoki acknowledged it well. He was like, yeah, you got me.
Aoki almost static at times. So focused, is he?
He's just waiting for the takedown. You know what Aoki's going to do. He's going to get to the clinch, try to get the takedown, but can you stop it? That's the question. That's the puzzle everybody's been trying to solve in one championship.
Oh, kick to the knee from Eduard. Hard feet. He's got hard shins.
He needs to keep doing that over and over again, attacking those legs, because that's going to limit the movement of Aoki.
The strength of that punch. Aoki backed off. Just hit him in the chest, I think. Oh, but there we go again. Again, it was low. There's the spinning back kick. Getting a bit of momentum now. The kick to the torso. The crowd getting behind Folayang. There'll be plenty of Filipinos here in Singapore. Punch to the body. Is that an area of potential weakness for Shinya? And Eduard Folayang ends the second round on the up and up.
That was a better round for Folayang. He was able to use the strikes and start to open up. And he's really starting to dictate the space. There's that big head kick and spinning back that they just barely missed. Big attempt, good, he stopped the takedown. These are moral victories. These are gonna add to his confidence. You can see Folayang immediately gets in the guard, keeps it nice and tight. Rich Franklin, what do you got so far?
Well, I'll tell you, Folayang had a couple takedown defenses in that round. They ended up on the ground, which wasn't a takedown by Aoki. However, Aoki added to his ground control lead. At the beginning of the round, it was really interesting to me because even though Folayang was moving side to side laterally, Aoki was moving in such a way that Folayang couldn't really commit to anything. He couldn't mount any damage on the feet. Anytime he committed, he knew he was going to end up on the ground. But at the end of that round there, you could see that Folayang was moving forward more and more, and Aoki was back. And at the end of that round, you could see that Folayang was landing the strikes. He closed the lead a little bit there, but still, if the fight was stopped at this point in time, Aoki would still have the decision.
I like what you're saying there, Mitch. Little moral victories here and there, confidence boosters for Folayang, just that he can bring forward, give himself a little bit of encouragement. The attack from Aoki.
There's that flying knee again. That is getting timed very well, but look at this. He's able to shrug.
Oh, and the knee to the head as well. And Folayang has got Shinya in trouble. Punches to the head. The noise behind me is deafening. Folayang looking for the finish. Shinya Aoki is standing very, very closely, watching hard. Nothing's coming back from Aoki. We're only half a minute into this third round. It's perpetual motion from the Filipino. And it is all over. We have a new ONE Championship lightweight title holder.
Hey guys, it's Misha Tate. If you want to see more awesome ONE Championship content, make sure you click that subscribe button. Click it so you don't miss it.